the concept. So today we're going to cover a pretty basic topic, but it's something that I'm sure everybody always has questions about. And it's, which primer do I use? Do I use this one? Do I use that one? Oh, well, that one looks good, or this one looks good, or I don't really know. But let's figure it out. Let's get into the nitty-gritty details of when you should use different primers, different sealers, things like that, and pretty much lay it out there. So that way you will know whenever you're doing custom painting, hydrographics, anything like that, you know which primer you need to go grab or you need to use on whatever part, all right? So to kind of start off, there's a couple of different primers out there. You've got a urethane primer and you've got an epoxy primer, all right? The urethane primers are good for like sanding body work, if you need to smooth anything out. They're also good for sealers, all right? Then you also have your epoxy primers. Epoxy primers can be a really high build primer. So like if you do need to sand out work, you could also use epoxy primer. Epoxy primers are really good at two things. Number one, they're mostly always a direct to metal, all right? So they work really good with bare metal substrates, all right? The other thing is that they, even whenever they're cured out, they are very flexible, all right? And so what we've got in here, we're actually about to start painting these and getting these ready for a custom paint job, but I figured it'd be a great idea to shoot a video on which ones do you use for which process, all right? And so just to kind of get started, we've got some metal pieces that are hanging up right in here. So we've got like a winch fairly, and then we've got a couple of metal parts that go on to some LEDs. And so like on this right here, these are bare aluminum. So a bare metal, we're going to use our epoxy primer. Now, we're going to be shooting the direct to metal epoxy primer that we sell, the Liquid Concepts. It's the P250 and the P251. So that is a direct to metal. If you need to sand it, you can, but one thing to remember is that it's going to be a little bit slower drying. So you may have to wait like 6 to 12 hours or possibly even overnight before you can start to sand that down. So you're asking, okay, well, that's great, but I need something that's quicker. They do make things that's quicker, but sometimes you lose different performance on the material that you're shooting. So like if we were to shoot this with a urethane primer, they do make some hybrids that are like a urethane primer that's direct to metal. I'm not particularly fond of them, but they do make them, they are out there, all right? So what I like to do is use something that I know that's gonna work and it's gonna last, and especially for durability, longevity, the epoxy primer is the way to go. Now, if we went and shot an epoxy primer on this, we could actually go right back over it with a urethane primer or a sealer and we'd be fine, but really there's no need for that. So in this case, because they are bare metal, we're gonna go right back over them with a direct to metal epoxy primer. We'll prime it. If they come out really smooth, we're ready to go directly into the paint, and then we can either dip it or clear coat it and the job's done. All right, so over here, I've got a couple of different things. Of course, we've got some metal pieces over here, but I also have some wood pieces, all right? And so one thing about stocks, especially like wooden stocks like this, you can use either primer you want. You can use an epoxy primer or you can use a urethane primer. In this case, what we're actually going to do is we're gonna use a urethane sealer, all right? And so some people are probably like, well, what is a sealer, all right? So just to kind of break it down into very easy terms, you have a primer and you have a sealer, all right? So a primer lays on, let's just say, that thick. A sealer may lay on this thick. And so the difference is that the primers are normally a little bit thicker, all right? So like our direct to metal epoxy primer, it can be shot as a sealer or it can be shot as a direct to metal epoxy primer. And so whenever you shoot it as a sealer, it makes it a lot thinner, but it makes it to where you can spray it on and then spray your base coat right over it. You don't have to sand it. You don't have to do anything like that to it. You literally just spray your primer down, and you spray your sealer down, you base coat right over the top of it, and then you're ready to go with either your clear coat or your dip, all right? But in this case, we're going to use a sealer. And so it's going to be just a regular urethane, a 2K urethane sealer. And so the sealer is going to do two things. Number one, it's going to be very easy to sand, and it's going to dry very quickly. So whereas before with our epoxy primer, we would have had to have waited like 6 hours, maybe even overnight. With this sealer, we can sit there and spray it, and then we can be sanding on it in, say, an hour or two, something like that. Sometimes, depending on shop conditions, it may be 30 minutes. But in this case, what we're gonna do is we're just gonna put it in as a sealer. So the other thing is that it's going to make it to where whenever we mix it as a sealer, it's also going to make it water resistant. So whenever we go and we put down the sealer on the wood, it makes it to where it resists all the water, and we don't have to worry about the wood soaking up the water. And so so essentially, that's the reason why we're gonna go with a 2K sealer on the wood, because it's gonna seal everything together, it's going to make it easy to sand if we do have to sand anything down, and it's one of those things where it's going to be a better product for this application. So again, every application is going to have a little bit different primer or something like that. So like I said, in this case, we've got our sealer on here. Now, could we shoot it with an epoxy primer? Sure, we certainly could, and it would still have the same effects. But the good thing about it is with a sealer, we can get to things quicker, and if it's already smooth, we don't have to sand it down, we can just go right over it. With an epoxy primer, you will have to wait a little bit longer if you do need to sand it. But because it's not a metal surface, then you don't have to worry about it, because we don't really need that really high build epoxy or anything like that. And plus, with it being wood, it's not flexible, so we're still fine with it being a urethane primer. All right, so if you'll kind of move around here, you can see we've got some folder plastics that are all set up here on our table. And so one thing that we always try to do is that we always try to apply a coating that's going to hold up and to last. So if I take this piece right here and I twist it and bend it and all of that, it's gonna hold, and it's going to hold up, all right? And so as y'all know, with foiler plastics, those things can bend and twist and all that, and you wanna make sure that you have a coating that's gonna hold to that. And so what we normally do is we will apply 1 to 2 coats of our adhesion promoter. It's our APL1. And then we will spray these with an epoxy primer. And then we're going to reduce it down into a sealer, so it makes it a lot smoother. Now, these are a little bit textured, and so we're going to probably put down about 2 or 3 coats of the sealer, just to make sure that we have enough primer to actually sand it back down. Now, could we mix it just as a epoxy primer and spray it on? Sure, we could, but whenever you mix it as a sealer, it helps smooth everything out and gets it really nice and smooth. And so that's the reason why we're gonna do that. So on flexible plastics, that's what we normally like to do. And so, like I said, we're gonna take these, we're gonna spray them with the adhesion promoter, we're gonna take our direct-to-metal epoxy primer. Now, again, we're not painting metal, but it is flexible. And so that's where that epoxy primer really helps out and really works really well. And so we're gonna take the primer, and it mixes 2 to 1, but we can also add a reducer to it to make it into a sealer. And remember, the primer is say this thick, a sealer is say this thick. So we want those smaller coats, but in more coats. And so whenever we go to spray it, it'll all lay out really smooth. You won't get a lot of orange peel. I'm sure some of y'all have seen that. You mix up a primer, you spray it on there, and it just looks like this. You know, it's got tons of orange peel. That's something that you won't see whenever you mix it into a sealer. It lays down super smooth and gives you a really good finish, all right? So that's what we're going to end up doing with this. Now, after these are primed and sanded, we can do 1 of 2 things. We can come back with a urethane primer and go ahead and primer them like that. And so, like, one coat of the urethane primer, you're not really gonna have to worry too much about the flexibility because it's one very thin coat. Versus if we were to lay tons of urethane primer on these plastics and then you start to bend them, that urethane hardens so much that it's not as flexible, and so it can crack a lot easier. And so that's the reason why we like to try to lay down our epoxy primer, because it gives a lot more and it's able to take the flexing and the back and forth movement and all that like an ATV is gonna have all the time. So hopefully this right here has really helped you guys out on, you know, which primer do I use for what process, you know? What is a sealer? What is a primer? How do they spray? What do I need to do? In short, all the primers are just about the same, but there are subtle differences, like what I just kind of explained to you, that will really help out in knowing which coating to use for which product that you have. So I hope you enjoyed this video today. I know it was a little short, we didn't really do a lot, but hopefully this helped explain a lot more on what you really need to be doing as far as your foundation for your coating itself. And so I hope you guys enjoy this video. I know we always do, making them all the time. Love to see your comments and questions or anything like that. If you want to see other videos, definitely comment, and we'll definitely get those started as well. So again, primer, you definitely want to put that down to get a good foundation and a good adhesion, and knowing the right primer is definitely going to make your job come out in with a better looking coating in the end, all right? So I'm Brian from Liquid Concepts, and we're making hydrographics great again. I appreciate it, and we'll see you guys next time.